Mrs. Betty Holmes, the wife of the Rangers chairman and chief executive, being assisted in that role with a battery of photographers. For the first time in 9 years, the league championship flag is unfurled at Ibrox. Alistair Hood, the operations executive, checking things. There's Mrs. Holmes, naturally dressed in blue. And the celebrations starting again among the Rangers fans. So there's always a special tingle about the first day of a new season, and this is certainly no exception. Perfect setting with Ibrox packed to capacity, the pitch in marvellous condition, and two top-class teams in view. All the formalities over, it's now down to the real business. And both sides, of course, decimated by suspensions particularly and by injury to some extent on the United, but Rangers certainly have got problems without Souness, Butcher or Roberts, all out through suspension. And that's John McGregor conceding the first corner kick of the match. But the abundance of riches in the Rangers camp, meaning that Ian Durrant even can't get a game in the team today. He's in subs bench. And Jimmy Phillips from Bolton shows the esteem with which he's held in the Rangers management. So the corner kick will be taken by Alan Irvin, formerly Queen's Park, Everton, and then recently Crystal Palace. Cohen's header. Helped away by Falco, there's Dave Bowman. Dave Kirkwood played the United players onside, he was slow from the near post area. There's Irvin, and it's Cooper now breaking for Rangers. There's Cooper, now Cohen. McCoist on the far side, so they recovered from the virus which affected him last weekend. Falco beaten to the ball by Hegarty, and Falco was the offender in that challenge. So a free kick to Dundee United, which has already been taken, short back to Billy Thompson. Good header by Irvin. French again, this time Redford is onside. He has Jimmy Nicol covering. That's good play by Nicol. Phillips. McGregor helps it back to Woods. So United lining up with McAnally, Hegarty, Neary and Malpass at the back. In the middle of the field, Dave Bowman with Bannon on the left and Irvin on the right, and Redford joining French through the middle up front. This is McCoist. It's a good cross. There's Falco. And the covering player was Jim McAnally. But that was fine play from Ali McCoist in particular on the right, getting in a good cross for Falco, who held it up, tried to make the turn, appeared to lose his footing and allowed McAnally to clear. Falco again. And a good snap shot from Mark Falco. Again, linking well with Ali McCoist. So it was well set up, this move involving McCoist with a sideways pass to Falco for the snapshot. McGregor, there's Hegarty. Good headed pass by Cooper. Neary covering behind Hegarty. Beaumont, Bannon. Beaumont is clear in the middle, he's onside, a great chance for Dundee United. And a very poor finish initially, but Beaumont makes it on the rebound, and United are ahead. The Rangers defence badly caught out, 12 minutes of the match gone. And Dave Beaumont gets one of his rare goals for Dundee United. Breaking through the middle, the Rangers defence was caught square, a bad first effort, a rebound from Woods, and Beaumont made no mistake. Well, what an opening from Dundee United. Dave Beaumont coming from that midfield area, right in the middle. And there will be some questions asked, I've no doubt, in the Rangers camp about the squareness of the central defence, allowing Beaumont to break. The feature, of course, of United's play is the way in which their midfield players support the front men so rapidly. And Beaumont took full advantage. So, Fisher for Rangers. And the small contingent of them. savouring the moment. Good play from Nicol. That's towards Falco. Good control, turning well, and Billy Thompson at full stretch. Good goalkeeping by Thompson. With another excellent build-up involving Jimmy Nicol on the right for Rangers. Bowman's header. Redford, Bowman is through. Has he the pace to get away from Phillips? Well, I think you could take it from that shot that Dave Bowman made up his mind. He didn't have the necessary pace. Hegarty getting up early that time. The Rangers fans wanted a free kick, but the referee waves play on as Phillips wins it back for Rangers. Well, no question about that free kick. Irvine going in late. And suddenly referee Smith has some work to do out there. A warning for Al Irvine. Phillips goes forward. And the short free kick taken. Ferguson to Cooper. Ferguson has space now. Hoping to find Falco. Spinning off the head of Nicol, there's Irvin. Not quite what he intended. It's back with Cohen. There's Phillips. Well, pass intercepts. Barron couldn't keep the ball in play, so a throw to Rangers. Past the half-hour mark now, Dundee United leading by 1-0. And looking good value for that at this stage of the match. Well won by Hegarty. Well, this time, the foul is against the United centre-half. Well, I must confess, once again, to feeling that referee Smith was perhaps a little harsh. Hegarty going up behind Falco, and the referee judging that he was doing some climbing. So free kick it is to Rangers. John McGregor is there, so is Cooper and Jimmy Nicol. Four-man wall lined up for United. John McGregor, I think. Plenty of power, but straight at the wall. This is Phillips, good turn. Thompson at full stretch. There's Kirkwood. Off the line by Neri from McCoist. Scrambled away by Bowman. And a goal kick is given. The Rangers players want a penalty for handball. But they couldn't really have been much closer to the opening goal. It was Jimmy Phillips who did brilliantly to play the ball across the face of the goal. Kirkwood thumped it in. There was McCoist, and Neri was on the goal line. Then when the shot was driven in, it struck a United player, Dave Bowman it was. It appeared to play him rather than the player play the ball, so no penalty kick. Now Cooper. Inside to Monroe. Well tackled by Beaumont. Bowman to Redford. That's for French to chase, but Nicol read that early and came across. So we've had 1 minute added on for stoppages in the first half, but no more. There goes the half-time whistle. United leave a goal ahead. There's the goal scorer, David Bowman. It came in the 12th minute. Build up in midfield. The Rangers defence caught square as the ball came through. Bowman sprinting onto that pass. Going through in Woods. The first shot, not very strong, came back off Woods. And the rebound knocked in by Bowman. And that's the goal which gives United a lead, which I think they deserve at halftime. It's Rangers 0, Dundee United 1. Get the second half underway, leading by 1-0, provided by Dave Bowman in the 12th minute. And there's been a change, a significant change in the Rangers ranks. They've brought on a substitute, and the sub is number 12, Ian Durant, who's replaced Jimmy Phillips, who wore the number 10 jersey in the first half. Cohen took a knock from French as he won that tackle, but it's Cooper coming forward. Good running by McCoist, breaking away on that diagonal run from Hegarty and Neri. Still McCoist. There's a chance! Durant for the header. Well, that could scarcely have been closer. Rangers coming as near as they have in the match so far to an equaliser. It was superb play by McCoist on the run, running wide on the right, checking in inside David Neary, playing it across with the help of a deflection. In came Durant, and the header goes over the top. Bad luck for Ian Durant. Well, that move involving McCoist and Durant has certainly encouraged the Rangers fans. You hear the singing now. McCoist involved once more. Kirkwood going forward. This is Durant. Well, passes tackle. Beaumont wins it from McCoist. And Redford is offside. Now, he must have been just about 1 yard into the Rangers' half. Redford looks upset, and I think he misjudged that very slightly indeed. Harvey Cohen. Up goes Hegarty, breaks to Cooper, away from McAnally. Brilliantly saved by Thompson, and McAnally concedes the corner. Well, this was superb play by Davy Cooper. Dropped from the high ball, spun past his man, a driven shot, brilliantly saved. And the corner kick will be taken by the same man, Davy Cooper. Poor one once again. Now that's two or three bad corner kicks Davy Cooper has taken after coming very close to the equaliser. There's Hegarty's header. The Rangers have undoubtedly stepped up the pace at the start of the second half, determined to get back in turn as quickly as they can. And United defending resolutely. You wonder if there may be a place in the United ranks before long for John Holt, who's on the bench and who could add some steel to their defensive setup. Belfast beats McCoist in the air. There's Jimmy Nicol. Falco on the turn. A brilliant effort from Falco. Well, that would have been a magnificent goal. The ball coming in. It was Jimmy Nicol here who tried the shot for a goal. Doesn't catch it properly. A very quick turn from Falco. The fast shot and Billy Thompson at full stretch. The ball goes wide. Cooper simply kept play for the benefit of Dave Bowman. Redford sets off. There's Munro checking inside, runs into French. McGregor sorts it out. Good turn, Ferguson. Slow start to the match, Derek Ferguson, but beginning to look much more like himself now. Good header on by Falco. McCoist goes through. He's brought down by Thompson, and that is a penalty kick. No question about it. Thompson committed, bringing down McCoist. But it was down to the superb leap here by Falco, winning the ball from Neary. McCoist was through. Thompson was committed, and that undoubtedly is a penalty kick. So, a perfect opportunity for the equaliser, Ali McCoist. Will take it himself, I'm sure. Setting off on his goal-scoring record, he hopes, no doubt, for the new season. So McCoist against Billy Thompson. So Rangers have the chance to equalise with McCoist facing Thompson. Superbly taken. Rangers are back on level terms. It's Ali McCoist, not surprisingly, who does it. Thompson making a determined effort going across, but McCoist had the accuracy and the power to beat him. And the Rangers goal-scoring machine sets off in the new season. So, joy at last for the Rangers fans. They've given some tremendous support to their favourites. And now with 25 minutes of the second half gone, it's one each. And I'm sure we're going to have a tremendous closing 20 minutes. Rangers for sure will be going all out for the winner. There's Bowman going back. Rangers fans happy now. And that combination between Falco with his power in the air and McCoist with his sharpness on the ground, earning the equaliser for Rangers. McGregor now with Nicol. Kirkwood back to Nicol. Cohen. McCoist is onside, he does that well, a great chance for Rangers. Sheer frustration for McCoist. Now this is high-class striking from Rangers. They're running initially from McCoist to get away from the defence. The deliberate aim for the far corner, and there was the post to rescue Dundee United. Durant. That's a marvellous pass. There's Jimmy Nicol, well challenged by Redford. And the referee being advised by the linesman that Thompson carried the ball over. Now the short corner goes back to Ferguson. Thompson came and stopped. And he could have been punished. Came off the head of Falco in the end. But that slanted cross from Derek Ferguson, you can see Thompson start to come, then check out. He was caught in no man's land, but the header went wide. Pushing by Cohen. Free kick to United. David Neri. In for Hegarty. Touch on for Redford. And a golden opportunity goes a begging for Dundee United. Ian Redford playing against his old club. I think we might find here Hegarty's head flick on. It bounced a shade too high for Redford. He could loft it past Chris Woods and under the bar. Here's David Cooper for Rangers. Kirkwood. Falco. McCoist. And again, the link-up between Falco and McCoist always paying off for Rangers. The ball is chipped forward here. The header down by Falco, the first time shot by McCoist, and that wasn't far away. Hegarty under pressure from Falco, here's Ali McCoist. That was well struck, and Thompson was scrambling. So McCoist is conducting a one-man assault course on Billy Thompson. Once again, taking the pass from Falco, lining up the shooting chance, hitting that with lots of power, and Thompson a very relieved man. We see McAnally pick up the loose ball and play it back to him. Well, Hegarty once again has come forward. He'll be the target for the long throw. Up goes Hegarty, gets a touch. French screening the ball. Trying to find room to turn, still French. There's Kinnaird. Chances on for Bowman. And it's scrambled away for the corner. Well, Dundee United undoubtedly thinking in terms of victory themselves. It was well set up. This work by Hamish French, what a player he looks to be. Turning and looking for an opening, playing it forward. There was Paul Kinnaird hooking the ball across goal. Bowman was there, well tackled though, and it goes behind for the corner. There's Paul Kinnaird. And there goes the final whistle. A draw in the end, just about right. After United's dominance in the first half, Rangers hit back in the second half, and it was Ali McCoist, as so often the case in the all the last season. He was the man who got the vital equaliser for Rangers, brought down initially by Billy Thompson, and then striking home the penalty kick, which gives Rangers a share of the points, which they certainly merited on their second half performance.